Gott.
Das ist die only stream.
Skip, please.
Yeah, that means that maybe this map will be played again in the end.
Not maybe, definitely. And exactly in the wrong moment, I'll tell you that already.
Shouldn't this track be good for you if the others crash the end?
But the problem is that for some reason this map is kind of difficult, so whenever other people crash, they pretty much always crash before. So I'm the one that's in the lead, you know? And I'm then the one crashing the finish. That's how it was in the other match at least. Or this jump here is also really tight. One of the things. Yeah, in the end with the three poles, also pretty difficult for me.
Riolo, I think I have to close the stream then, because data volume, rip. I mean, I can get the world record, but I probably won't stream it. So, we are starting. Recorded, yeah, okay, I recorded. So we got two French players, Kronos and Cup, then Shorty and Razor. And Kronos had a really bad start in the season, so he definitely needs to win this match. Basically every one of these players has to win the match. I think Cap is the one who has the best position in the season. But all the others are fighting for the playoffs, for the top 16 places in the group stage. And wow, Razor with a nose slide. It looks like Kronos can do the full comeback from last place to first in this round. Razor with a nose slide in the last turn. Kronos taking the safe finish was a smart idea. And takes the first 10 points. And then he crashes the first turn. Shorty also with a crash, but Kronos is far behind. Kronos has to make sure that he can finish and at least get 3 points. We got a battle here in front between Razor and Cup. They are still very close to each other. Oh, different approaches on this left-hander. Razor going inside pole. Here we have Cup. This time Razor gets the slide in the last turn and he manages to finish, but Cap needs a bit and Shorty Yay! Snipes it.
Nice.
This little bug here, so weird. So Razor is taking the lead in the overall standings with 17 points. And Kronos a second. Now we have Shorty in the lead. Cap going for a very outside line, gaining a lot of speed here, but he can't really catch up to Shorty. Oh, Shorty with a crash, falls down to last place, and Kronos with a crash. Now falls down to last place and Razor with a crash. That means Shorty is second. Where's Cap? There. There is this hotkey. Oh, yeah, safe finish. It looked as if he wanted to go for the quick finish, but yeah. That couldn't have worked out. So now very close total standings. Cap in the lead. Kronos on second, and Racer didn't finish the round. Gets falls down to third place, and Shorty has the same points. All players within 3 points. Very close, but Kronos with another mistake. Still Racer with a different approach. Very interesting. But it's not really faster, it's like equal. It seems to be a bit more risky, but now he comes back and overtakes both Cap and Shorty. Oh, Cap with a big crash. Shorty can save it. But Racer, does he make the... Oh!
Yay!
Shorty takes over the first place by just going to the safe finish. It's probably the best solution to do in this map. And with that, Shorty is in the lead. Yeah, for all those guys here, this is a match that they definitely can win. It's a match that they have to win or get second place if they want to advance in the season rankings. Now we will play a new map. Well, Shorty, did you have enough time to train the new maps?
Well, I played this map pretty much as others, but this is not really a style where I am fast on. So I am kind of slow here. It's a really interesting map, the style of it.
Yeah.
You can get a gear down in that turn here, but besides that, it's a really nice map, I think.
Yeah, that's Shorty.
It's a very interesting style.
Yeah, yeah, I saw a lot of platform and blue turns. Not many street parts on this map.
A lot of transitions.
Yeah, transitions. But an easy finish.
Sort
compared
of.
To other maps.
Need to hit it really good, else you're fucked, but compared to the map before, pretty much every finish is easy.
Well, I just only saw the expert match on this map, and yeah, the finish looked quite easy.
Yeah, it's not too hard if you're hitting it, and it's not too difficult to hit it well.
So, Kronos with a bad start again. He's often behind in the start. But Cap with a mistake, Shorty with a mistake. Leaving Racer alone at the top. But Kronos is not really out of that round. He can catch up to Racer maybe. But at the moment, Racer is extending his lead. Also Cap. Where did we have him? Oh, he just crashed. He was close to Kronos. Shorty on third can pretty much save it. So let's see. Kronos versus Racer. Is the fight for first place? Ah, Kronos with a better turn, but now he does not have a lot of speed. Oh, Shorty snipes again. Yeah, very easy finish, champ, as you see. Well, you can't complain about how the match goes. Kronos with another bad start, but oh yeah. But Cap also struggled. He's 9/10 behind. It's just Shorty versus Racer for the win at the moment. But Shorty has a way better turn here. Also, this one is better. Racer's falling a little bit behind. And this turn was very good by Racer. Also, this transition and the upcoming jump was very good. He overtook Shorty now, who gets a better transition here. So, the last turns will decide. Shorty goes for the inside approach. Oh, Racer crashes. Shorty could release there. After he saw that Racer crashed, he instantly released. Otherwise, that would have been a crash for sure. So, Shorty takes first place. Other guys are doing mistakes. Sometimes it's good to just finish. So the Kronos this time have a better start. Oh, he's really he's taking some airtime at the top of the uphill block at the start. That's really weird. So he's losing some time again. But he's in front of Shorty at the moment, but he has a very bad line here. Racer in the lead, but Cap is very close to him, and Cap definitely needs the points to catch up to Racer and Shorty in the total standings. So Shorty takes over third in this round, and comes very close to the first two positions as well. But Kronos now also with a good turn, or much inside line there. Three guys battle for the second place, and of course second place belongs to the one and only Shorty. Yeah, Racer crashed last turn, falls behind. Cup is overtaking Racer in the total standings. Shorty and the lead. And Kronos has like 10 points disadvantage to the next player. It's really weird with Kronos. At the first two play days, he of course had this final in ESL. So he was not that trained for TMPL, obviously. But I assume to see him better now that he trains the maps, and he usually is one of the best players in the game. But somehow he still struggles and just can't win those matches. He gets a lot of third and fourth places. He's pretty much last place in the season. Very weird. If he wants to reach the playoffs, he has to step up. He really needs to get good points finally, especially in those rather easy matches. He definitely needs to win or get second place at least. But also this match doesn't seem to go in his favor. He's probably still not trained enough. While I was speaking that, Cap won the round and comes close to Shorty now with two wins in a row. Also Shorty got last position. That means that Cap is now just 1 point behind Shorty, and Racer only 5 points. So it's getting closer again, definitely. Next map is Peekaboo by Roa and Omnipod. A map that we know from the first playday. Or since the first playday. With a difficult finish jump. Let's see how these players will do it. I wanted to look for a moment the total standings in the season. That might be interesting to see. So, we got Shorty on 17th place at the moment. Kronos just with one single point. Shorty has 6 points. Kronos is like last just in front of Onyo, who doesn't drive anymore. Then we have Racer with 5 points. He's just 1 point behind Shorty and on 19th place in the season. And we got Cap. Cap has 8 points and is on 11th place. Might be interesting to know. So Cap is the best placed driver in the season and currently he's on 2nd place. Racer and Shorty are pretty much at the same points in the season and will fight here. Shorty will try to keep ahead of keep himself ahead of Racer, because this is like the decisive match maybe if Wu will make it in the top 16 and Wu is out of top 16 and Wu will not advance to playoffs. So maybe Kronos will do a little bit better on this map because he played it in a lot of matches already. Matches are also a good training, of course. Ah, he's taking over first place after Racer makes a mistake. And Racer falls back even more. Oh, Shorty with a mistake. Hits the wall on the left side. Now the end will decide. Everything stays like it is at the moment. I'm not sure if Racer has enough speed. Probably yes. Yeah, he has. But Cap finishes last. Important points for Kronos. The top three are now very, very close together. And Kronos is just 10 points behind. At the moment it looks to be a match that will be decided in the end as well, in the finalist status. Where's Kronos? Ah, he's still in. All four players without any mistakes, but we see Shorty and Kronos a little bit behind and Cap and Racer in front. Different lines through this banked turn, but equal fast. Oh, Racer gets too low at that block, gets the auto slide and falls back to last place. And Kronos is taking the risks, tries to overtake Cap for first place because he really needs those first places. And he has a good line here, but he had to release a little bit. It still looks good for Cap. Did Cap release there? Well, yeah, I think Cap still manages to finish, but he lost the first place to Kronos because he jumped more diagonal and he probably had to release a little bit in the last drift. And then it wasn't enough to jump over the finish block or on the finish block. A different line by Racer. He came from outside, got the turn, and with his overspeed he went to first place. Interesting. We don't see a lot of mistakes on this map. Not big crashes like it was on the previous map, which of course was a new map, so people were not that trained. But here it looks pretty decent by all players. Oh, Kronos with a good speed. Shorty lost some speed there, but comes back in this hairpin. Race on the lead. All four players are still very close together. Here's Cap, he's on last place, but still near Shorty, but the last turn is coming up and everyone is doing the finish jump correctly, without problems. Racer takes 10 points and he will go to into the lead now, alone. Ah no, it's already... That are already the point standing, so Racer is together with Shorty in the lead. 3 points ahead of Cap and Kronos with a good map here. Did the comeback and that's just 4 points behind the first place, so now it's really close. It's like we start at zero and have a point limit of 50. Cap is now taking over first place. Shorty in last position, Kronos third. It's a battle between Racer and Cap now for the first place. Racer with more speed out of the hairpin. Oh, Cap with a crash. That will cost him more than just this position. Shorty is gonna overtake him as well, and Kronos won't, but no. Cap has to take the safe finish, and then he will also be overtaken by Kronos.
Oh my god,
no, he won't. Tailed
it. Kronos jumped against the right side of the finish.
Yeah, he could have overtaken Cap there. So warm up on the next map, a new map. It's called Mech Oasis by Gruff. I saw one match on this map, and I remember we had a lot of close races here, so maybe it's not the most difficult one, but maybe Shorty can tell something about it.
I'm slow as fuck here. It's not that difficult, but there are some places where you can crash. If you pay a little bit attention, then usually you shouldn't crash that much on this map. Except the ending might be a little bit challenging, but yeah, I mean, it's CMBL, so we are sort of used to those finishes.
Yes.
And it's a kind of known one, with the half pipe into the finish jump.
Yeah, that's a finish that we already saw often.
Directly after the loop, but not a challenge.
Yeah. Well, in the expert match, nobody failed it. So, we are starting. Oh yeah, Shorty is falling back on the last place. Also, Razor struggles a bit. Can't really keep up with the two guys in front. So, at the moment, I would say Kronos is pretty good prepared on this map, and maybe he can overtake all other players now in the total standings if he manages to win some rounds. But at the moment here he is having a really bad line, so Cap is taking over the lead. Razor, as we saw, completely crashed out of the round. I'm not sure if he can finish. Let's see if he... no, he can't finish. So Cap, Kronos, and Shorty is taking the safe finish. Well, it's so close in the standings. Crazy. Razor falls back to third. Shorty and Cap together at the lead. Oh! There was another crash by Razor. That seems to be a bad map for Razor, and also Kronos made a mistake, but he's still in front. No, Razor's overtaking him. Well, they will have a fight for sure. They will have a fight, but let's see the fight between Cap and Shorty, which is not really a fight at the moment. Cap can make huge steps to the win on this map, it seems. If he is able to make many wins, then he will get a lead, definitely. So let's see the fight between Kronos and Razor, that's still very close. Kronos seems to... Wow, nice turn by Kronos. He's on third place now, but he risks the finish, but he gets it. Cap with a 102.14, which is, yeah, a decent time. We saw better times in the expert match, but yeah, that's with Pack and Massa and so on. That's nothing surprising, but that's definitely a very decent time. And he seems to be the fastest player here. Let's spectate him for a moment. He's again in the lead, but still in a fight with Razor. Also, Shorty's not far behind. Kronos with a mistake already. Oh, Razor. He took the risk of an inside line in this turn, but he came through and took over the lead. Oh, Cup with low speed after this turn. He will fall back. Also, Shorty can overtake him now. Very important for the other players to deny Cap more 10 points on this map. Cap and Shorty now in front. Yes, he got it. He got the top finish and gets another second place. Racer now with a 0.19. So now the points are 96 for Cap, 95 for Shorty, and 92 for Racer. It keeps to be a very close fight. Also, Kronos is still not far behind. But he lost some points in the last two rounds when he crashed. Cap with a good start, has a big lead already in front of Kronos. Shorty is third and Razor has crashed. Where is he? 3 seconds behind. He's popping up in the CP standings at the bottom right. So he definitely can finish this round and get 3 points. But it's still a bad round for him because he will lose even more points to Cap and Shorty in the total standings. And Kronos will get closer to him. Kronos at the moment at the second place. It seems to stay like it is. Let's see if they get the finish jump. Yes, both get it. Shorty probably took the safe one. And Razor also finishes. He got over 5 seconds in the end. Barely finished. What the fuck, Scotsman? 101 viewer. Crazy. Thanks for hosting. So, we're moving to the map Spectra by MD Point. And yeah, for the new viewers, I'm gonna show you the standings. 106 for Cap, 100 for Shorty, 95 for Razor and 90 for Kronos. The whole match, it was a really close fight between all players. Kronos was all the time behind. At some point he was like 10 points behind, but he came closer again. Now he was falling back on the previous map, which was a new map by the other map.
But the other map.
Yeah, the other new map by Kraft. Cap played really good on that map and got a lead now, but it still seems to be a match with many finalists at the same time.
They didn't even tell the best part. You know what map comes after this? Blaze.
Yeah. We have this map. Maybe Cap can finish it here already. Let's see. But if the match is not finished on this map, then we will move to the map Blaze with a very difficult finish. So, now it starts. The deciding rounds will come now on a map that we know since the first play day, so all players are kinda well prepared here. That will be some close matches for sure, some close rounds. but Captain Kronos struggled a bit at the start. They lost some time. Oh, Cap with a big mistake. Can he finish? Oh yes, but that seemed to be a very lucky one. But he will just take 3 points, probably, and if it's the case, then he will have 109 and will not be able to get finalist status in the next round. Very unlucky for him. But maybe someone makes a mistake and he can take advantage of that. Razor seems to get the first place, and that's really important for him. Oh, Kronos with a big mistake. Can Cup overtake him? I don't think so. Oh, Razor with a mistake! Wow, wow, that's really... Shorty can take the safe finish, I think. Yeah, he can. The pressure's high. All guys are making huge mistakes. Just Shorty survived this round. And yeah, this is a very important round for Shorty, and Razor even can't finish. He was close to first place, but now he's falling back. Now he's tied with Kronos on the last place. Unlucky for Razor. Oh, and there comes the next crash. He's tilting now, probably. Cap needs first or second to get finalist status. He took advantage of Razor's mistake. And also Kronos' mistake in the end, I think. So Shorty can also reach finalist status if he wins this round. But Kronos is first at the moment, and Shorty doesn't have really a good line here. He loses more time. So it's Cap who can maybe challenge Kronos, but Cap doesn't really have to. He has 0.3 advantage to Shorty, and all he needs is top 2 placement. But we have this interesting finish jump, and I think his fingers will be very shaky now, because he needs to secure that, but Kronos is crashing. Now he can take the safe one. No, he's going for the risk one, but he gets it. Shorty with a second place will move to 117 points, which means that he can get finalist status if he just finishes. And he has a big gap to third and fourth place, which is nice to have, definitely. Oh, already a mistake. But yeah, it's Cap who can win this match now. So it's a difficult task for Shorty. Should he save now and just finish, or should he challenge Cap? Oh, Cap with a mistake, so that's like decided already. Cap won't win now. He's on last place. Razor's taking over third. And just Kronos and Shorty are battling for first and second. And yeah, Shorty also doesn't really need to take any risks now. He just needs 3 points. That's all he wants. Yeah, you see his white line there. So Razor can maybe overtake Shorty. Oh, Kronos with a bad line. Oh, wow. Oh, he gets even a slowdown there. Razor takes over first place. Oh my god, Kronos. Oh, Kronos. That's like the most unlucky thing, but not only unlucky, it's... yeah. Well, he stays at 100 points. Good job by Razor. And now we have 2 finalists. Oh, Kronos is out of the round already. Now he's a bit tilting. Shorty with a white line falls back to third place. And this is the round where Cap can finish the match. He definitely has the best start and the best opportunity, but what is he doing? Boy, he survived it. He somehow survived it, and he is still in first. Oh, that was kind of lucky, I must say. I mean, sometimes I see people clipping the edge, but he clipped it really hard. That was crazy. Oh, Shorty now crashes. Probably Kronos will overtake him. Yes, it seems like this. At least they will have a battle. No, Kronos crashes. But now it's a battle between Razor and Cap. Can Razor deny Cap the first place? Oh, Razor with a very, very risky turn there. And he's taking over first place for the moment. The last turn will decide. Oh, Razor with a lot of drifts, but he makes the finish, he makes the jump, and he stays ahead of Cap. He denies it and moves to 118 points. So just 2 points away from also getting the finalist status. And yeah, now we have the...
Oh yeah.
The deciding map.
I've been waiting for this. No.
Now we move again to the first map, which is TM Pro League Blaze by Santana. And yeah, it has a very, very difficult finish, and we saw a lot of mistakes when we played the match the first time. Or the map the first time, I mean. You can hear that Shorty doesn't really like it, that it's decided on this map.
But it wouldn't be the first time that I screw up because of it. But maybe because I screwed up in the first match and the second match it goes well.
Maybe.
I hope so.
Well, other players also did mistakes here, definitely. So everything is possible. At least third place seems to be pretty safe. Kronos is only at 103 points. So if Kronos doesn't win the rounds, then he probably will keep last position. So, let's see. Cap versus Shorty, second time. But Razor, close to also getting finalist. But he needs to finish. And on the other hand, he needs to deny if he wants to get the first place. So that needs some risks, and yeah, he's already out. So he will just make sure that he finishes. And we have a battle between Cap and Shorty. But not on the track at the moment. Shorty had a slow start and fall behind. Now it's the question if it's a good sign if Kronos is denying Cap, or is it a bad sign because Kronos might even come closer to Shorty? I don't know, but at the end it seems to be just about if Cap makes a mistake or not. Ah, Kronos is risking now. He's coming closer, and now this end will decide. Can Cap get the fast finish? Oh! Yes, oh my god, 4 thousandths of a second. Kronos with the inside approach and at the finish. And Cap was like parallel to the finish line. But still, he kept 4 thousandths of a lead. Crazy. Yeah. And now we have Razor and Shorty battling for the second position. And Kronos needs to win this round. He needs to win if he wants to get something better than fourth. Because if he doesn't win this round, then the match is over and he has less points than Shorty and Razor and will get fourth place. And at the moment it seems that Kronos is having a good round, but he's losing a lot of speed here, so Shorty and Razor catch up. This will be very close. The last drifts will decide this round. And Shorty is risking it now. Oh, nice. Razor seems to have crashed, I think. Yes, Razor crashed. Kronos with a bad line. Shorty takes it. Nice. Yeah, second place belongs to Shorty still. 59.66.
This round, though, it was faster than the one from Cap previously.
Yeah.
Well, I won't complain, I'm happy.
Nice fight, and as Kronos didn't finish first, he is last now because the match is finished. Razor takes third. And in the season, that means that Cap Wu was placed the best already between those four players. He will advance even more in the rankings. And Shorty Won a point against Razor, which might be very important in the end if they want to reach the playoffs. And Kronos, yeah, he still is down to just one single point. He needs to step up. Definitely needs to step up. If he wants to join the top 16 players in the season.